Alrighty then, folks, welcome back to Gihren's Great Earth Federation Force of Campaign. So, in the last episode, we attacked Luna 2, we almost attacked this place and ran away, and we found out that Soloman only has one defender. And so we're going to have a huge fleet attack Soloman. Though I realized something in the last few minutes since I stopped recording. There's only one guy in here. There's no point in sending 47 guys at them. So instead, we're going to move these guys here, send them here to grab this place. We're going to have everyone in here go straight down to here, grab side 6, and do all that stuff. I explained that last episode. If you don't know, go rewatch it. We might lose side 1, but who cares? We'll go recapture it. We're gonna make Slugger survive, though. Which will be awesome. Whoops, I need to be quiet. So, that's basically all we can do this episode. Or this part. We do have a Blue Destiny 3. We're about to have that new type stuff, or the Gundam Alex stuff. Which then we'll get some Gundam Alexes. We might upgrade a couple of them to Gundam Alexes. Probably not many. Because I think the G3 can upgrade straight into a Gundam Mark II. I could be wrong, though. So, first and foremost, we gotta finish this battle up. So, we want these guys to go through there. Attack there. We want this white base to go over here. We want basically everyone to fire on this Deve. Okay. Spreading particles isn't necessary. Or at least in my opinion, it isn't. I probably will do it a little bit. Have I overloaded? I have overloaded. But we should be able to destroy them just fine. Oh. Oh yeah, sure, why not? Then we'll send this guy over as well. Hopefully we'll be able to end this battle this turn. That's if the Teve gets shot down. We'll definitely kill that Zaku, though. Mm-hmm. Alright. Okay, and we should definitely kill this Teve. Teve. It's not a Teve yet. Okay, and we won. Hopefully Soloman will be this easy. But hey, our main force is here, so we're going to move them to attack A Bao Qu. And now the Battle of Soloman. We're going to rush with our white bases and have everyone else pick up the slack. We got to do this before 3 turns are up. If not, we're going to have to fight a big Zom with units that can't even attack it. Which is going to be interesting, but we should be able to move to like there next turn. And then we'll have like 6 snipers beat the crap out of them in one turn. Plus more, actually, because we'll also have the white bases firing on them. Alright, so, not able to move as far as I thought, but oh well. You cannot attack, and spreading particles is meaningless. But most of these have snipers in them, right? Yeah, so, they just have to be able to deploy to here. Watch us destroy him in, like, this turn. Just, like, random firing and we kill him. Oh, and some Zaku F2s. Damn. I was hoping we'd actually kill him. Goddamn, what a suggestion. Didn't work. Okay. Solar system no hasha wa kanou ka?
Oh, well then.
30% of their forces got destroyed. They have one of them. GMs can't move close enough. Snipers can move close enough. One second, people. Come on in, girl. Okay. Just letting my cat out that I... or letting my cat back in that I let out like 3 episodes ago. So now you have a vague timeline of when I actually did it. Yeah, so we should definitely kill them. Like, there's no chance we won't. I should have had that other white base go and scan, but oh well. We did it. And that guy, who I don't remember his name. I think he was from Stardust Memory. Okay. So, we're gonna leave troops in Soloman though, because eventually units are gonna attack Soloman, but we just defeated it without Slugger dying. I'm like really happy about that. Let's see, what do they have? They have 3 Zakus, probably of the radar variety. Or Zaku F2s, actually. I didn't look what they were producing. So, we're gonna send these guys over to here. I need to be quiet. I apologize. Well, I shouldn't apologize to you guys. You guys don't care. But it's like 2 in the morning and my neighbors keep complaining. So... they're all going towards the center, so we're just preparing to drop units near the center to attack them. Okay, and we'll send them there. And the center's right here, if you don't know. And that saberfish can't capture the base, so we'll just leave it. Oh, they didn't move into the base. Maybe I got the center off. Maybe they consider this the center, though I'd say that one's more of a center, but oh well. Yeah, a bunch of Zaku F2s. Oh yeah, okay. So, thinking about that, I am going to spread particles back here so we get a little bit of cover, even if it's not much. We should destroy him also. I would be surprised if we don't. And we didn't. I didn't think they would get past the range phase. But we did destroy them, so it's all good. Oh, and they have 1 guy inside 6. Awesome. Let's see, it is... fuck, they brought a Guazine. Just a Guazine, too. Okay, so... we're going to load up 3 Gundams into this here white base. And another GM. We're going to send this unit forward. I'm saying Dalaz this time. I'm actually just gonna leave these guys because we... nah, actually, I'll bring them. I'm gonna say I'll leave them because we don't really need them, but why not? And let's load up these GMs into that. They're going to go towards the center, then we're gonna reach the center, we're gonna battle for a few turns, and then they're gonna die. Watch that not be a Gwazine either and be like a good Celadon. I'm pretty sure, though, it's a Gwazine. And our Gundam carrying Musai. We won't finish this battle this turn just because we'll barely reach them by the end of the five turns. But, yeah, we should win this one hands down. It won't even really be a contest. Okay. Okay. So, we're not gonna attack. I was gonna see if we could scan, but we can't. That white base is going to get hit a little bit, but it's at full HP, so who cares? Okay, and we'll eject troops and have them attack that Gwazine next turn. We probably won't destroy it this turn, but yeah, I'm not gonna fire back. Yep, but it's definitely a Gwazine. I don't know why the hell they sent a singular Gwazine at us. Okay, so we want AG3, AGM, AGM to go here and attack. We want them to go do the same thing from here. And then we're going to have you move up, and you're going to scan. And it's Dalaz. Sweet. And yes, that was just a guess. I didn't actually know that that was going to happen. But I'm happy it did. Wonder if Chalia Zeon's gonna rebel. Make it interesting. It would suck because it would make the campaign much longer, but it'd make it interesting. So, next turn we will surround and destroy them. But for now, I think we're only gonna damage them a bit. Yeah. Got him down to half health. Or 335. And he's gonna fire at someone who can't fire back. Yep. A GM and two gun cannons. No one got destroyed though, so it didn't do anything. Yeah. Ah, and then this one. Should be a quick battle. So, these guys will go forward, capture this base. We'll go line them up. This is all just reaching them. There's, like, nothing left for this battle. Though it looks like they have three Zaku R2s. But I do not know. At least that top one's an R2. So. We'll probably do our usual thing, eject the snipers and have the two G3s and the GM will go up and melee them, have the snipers fire on support, have the white base help out, scan first, then have them fire. Oh, and they sent somebody out to attack the white base. That works. We'll have that unit following us attack them. Or it's actually two units, so... Whoops. Sorry, I didn't show you guys. I clicked the wrong button. They can't reach, but... Okay, so you three will attack there. This is a Zaku S with Cadillac in it. And that guy in a Zaku F2. And a Zaku R1 with no pilot. Yeah, I have no doubt the Gundam will be able to destroy them, and... then the sniper should take out the ones in the base. And Rainer's killing Cadillac. Though she is in S1, so she's really likely to die first. Whoops. And if they survived that, they would have just hit the white base anyway. And then we'd have everyone attack them next turn. Okay, so basically everyone we can will be attacking A Bao Qu next turn. Do we want to disband the 13th Autonomous Unit? The answer is no. Okay. They'll be asking us that for 5 turns.
レビル将軍
Do we want to make the 13th Autonomous a new type unit? Answer is yes. There's absolutely no reason to saying, or this is how you restart the white base events if you mess them up before. But yeah, there's absolutely no reason to say no besides ending white base mode. And I don't like the effect they use to process his voice, it's weird.
Side3の頃にで強制疎開が行われていたことと何か関係があるのではないでしょうか?
And they completed the solar array. Alright. Oh, yeah. Free money credits and resources.
We got
3rd Gray Phantom. We will be upgrading everyone immediately. So, with all these guys, we have... them two, they're going to here. Let's see, they have 0 there, they have 4 there. So, what we want to do is we want to send these 3 snipers to here, and we... well, first we're going to send everyone to here, then we'll send those 3 snipers to go capture here. And these guys will all go to here. It'll take them a few turns, and these guys will all go to here. So, we'll have a massive battle for A Bao Qu. They have 15 there, 6 there, 1 there, but they're producing an R2, an F2, and a Jiko. We're going to have the 28 move to there. That one has 0, so we'll just have... we'll have this unit move in and grab it, because they can. These guys will probably come to fight us here, but we'll destroy them. We won't move here because every turn we occupy this province, we take 5% law penalty. And we're at about 80% basically. So yeah. And what do we have here? We have, ooh, Gray Phantoms can actually hold 9. We have a white base. Okay, I accidentally stopped white base mode. That's not that bad, though. Fuck. We do have Amuro, who's rank B. We're gonna have to fight a Zeon, and we have Kai, who's also rank B. We're gonna have to fight a Zeon at A Bao Qu right now. And Slager's still alive. We have Selah because I've beaten this multiple times. We have Hayato, who's also rank B. They're really high level. Bright. We have Fra Bo. Yes. Henkin, that guy. Mirai, who's also rank B. Okay. So, you know what? I'm just going to end the episode here. And I'll just end the recording session here, basically. If you guys want me to stay without white base mode turned off, I will. But if you guys want me to, I can go back and rebeat all the battles and stuff and turn white base mode back on. So it's up to you guys. Do you want me to keep white base mode off so we don't get to murder Lalah, but we miss out some of the events and then we have to fight a Zeon when we attack A Bao Qu? It's the broken Zeon, not the good one. Or do you want me to turn it back on so we get to watch all the events? Which most of it's just mentions. There's not really anything exciting about it. It's up to you guys, though. So, if you guys enjoyed this episode, you should like it. Goodbye.